This is a no magnet motor because it does not use ferrite magnets. Instead, you make an electromagnet. You need insulated copper wire, a battery. Take a meter long 25 gauge insulated copper wire and wind it round and round on a new 1.5 volt battery. Remove the coil, it will be look like a spring, and then tie knots on the two ends and pull them out. So the coil will become like a circle with two ends. Now this wire is insulated and you scrape the insulation completely from one end. You'll see shining copper. On the other side, you just scrape the top, the left and the right, only three sides. One side would be totally copper, the other side would be scraped on three sides copper, but one side would be insulation. Then you take a sewing machine bobbin and wind insulated copper wire fully on this bobbin. Scrape both the ends to remove the insulation and you'll see shining copper. When current will flow through this bobbin, it would become like an electromagnet. Now take a 1 centimeter wide rubber band from an old bicycle tube. Take two long safety pins and snug them to the plus and the minus of the battery. Now take the bobbin with the wire wrapped upon it, place in the middle of the battery and connect both the ends of the wire to the pins. Now current is flowing through the coil and it has become an electromagnet. Now you keep the moving coil on top. You just need to give it a gentle nudge and the coil will keep spinning. On a brand new battery, this motor would last for almost 45 minutes. This is a no magnet motor. You can see the top view. There is an electromagnet in the middle. And of course, the spinning coil also becomes an electromagnet. And if you bring another magnet on top, well, depending upon which polarity you bring, it will become slow or it will run faster.